Sunday of Epiphany is from the Gospel according to Matthew, the 5th chapter.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus says, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven." And this is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
Please be seated. Brothers and sisters in Christ, praise to you and peace from God our Father, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hear again the words of the Lord. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Many of you have seen me do this, many of you have not. So, one of my favorite things to do. So Jesus says we are the light of the world. And Jesus tells us to let our light so shine before others that they can see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Couple of important things. We're the light. Isn't that amazing? The creator of the universe says, "You are the light of the world." I don't know about you, but that kind of gives me the willies a little bit, because sometimes I kind of like to live in the dark house. Sometimes I kind of like people not to know my inventory. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes it feels like the world is just out to extinguish my light. The Holy Spirit lives within me, and because of that living within me, come on, light. And even when it seems quiet from God, our light continues to shine. Because it's beyond us. It's beyond our doing. It's beyond our full capabilities. We are called to be light. We are called to be salt. But the Holy Spirit within us is the generator of that light. Jesus Christ came to show us the idea and the vision that God had from the very beginning of his creation, to live in community, to love one another, to care for one another, to pray for one another. And the world will say, "Don't do that. Stop it. Don't be a light. Instead, squawk at one another and fight with one another and forget that all people on this planet are precious to God. All people, past, present, and future, are beloved by the Creator who wants to be in relationship with us." I don't know about you, but I find that hard to believe. Some days. Some days my faith gets weak and I just feel like there's just nothing to count on. But still, the Holy Spirit dwelling within me and in you brings us to the reality that we are the light of the world. And we're salt. Years ago, when I was in high school, my mother developed high blood pressure, dangerously so. She was really, really sick and spent a week in the hospital. And I had to go to school every day and I had to work right after school. And so it was real hard for me to bit into it and almost spit it back out, guess what there wasn't in that bread? High blood pressure is your clue. There was no salt in that bread. Oh, man! That's just nasty. And she said, yeah, they've been making me eat this every day. I felt so bad for her. And coming back home, we didn't have salt on the table after that. It was Mrs. Dad. We got real familiar with Mrs. Dad. She'd always wondered what happened to Mrs. Dad. I digress. But it really drove home to me that Jesus calls us the salt of the world. You are to be salty. You are to tell others about Jesus. You are to live your life in such a way that you're giving glory to God. You're living your life in such a way that people say, I want what they have. I want what you have. I want to live a life free from fear, free from wondering, is this it? Is this little journey on our planet all that there is, or is the reality that we serve a higher, more noble purpose? That God has invited us to be a part of His kingdom, witness, and ministry. How often do we pray, oh God, please feed the hungry, and God says, you give them something to eat. How often do we say, oh God, they're so thirsty, can you give them something to drink, and God says, you give them something to drink. It's so simple, but we want us to just put it all off on God to do, and God says, yeah, I gave you the wherewithal to help others. I gave you the power to be a force to be reckoned with. I want you to think about this for a minute. When Jesus ascended back into heaven, the first chapter of Acts tells us he had 120 followers. 120 followers after 3 years of ministry where he did amazing things. He did things like heal people. He literally put new eyes in a blind man's face because he was born blind at birth. He raised people from death. And he told us about God's kingdom vision where it was one of grace and mercy and love and peace and not one of condemnation and fear of a righteous God striking us dead someday. We've been called to share this good news. We've been called to be salty. And we've been called to be the light of the world. The light that no darkness can overcome is Jesus Christ. And he willingly shares that light with each and every one of us. We say it here in baptism at the very end. We say, let your light so shine before others that they can see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. In other words, when we do something good, just keep going. You're doing what you're supposed to do. It's like praising your child for getting up in the morning. They're supposed to get up in the morning. Or for praising somebody to do their job when they're supposed to do their job. And we will always want that. Everybody wants a trophy. Well, the trophy is eternal life. The trophy is God's gracious love and mercy poured out for all people. It is such a wonderful opportunity for us to always remember how beloved we are. And to share that good news. And not live in fear, but to live in the peace and hope of what it means to live in God's kingdom today. Not someday in the future, but today. Because we are the light, we are the salt, and we are beloved children of God. Thanks be to God for this great gift. Amen.